From humble beginnings on Chicago's South Side, playing basketball over at De La Salle High School, being drafted number one overall in the country out of Loyola University here in Chicago back in 1972, you'd think that LaRue Martin would have this storied career in basketball, being the number one draft pick. Didn't turn out that way. Instead, he had a storied career at UPS over 30 years, where he has risen to the ranks of being the contact for Mr. Barack Obama to many others. We're going to hear his story right now and how he truly is one of Chicago's very own. I'm borrowing a page from Chicago's very own, because it is a very Chicago scene type of segment, because the man, even though retired, still works at the UPS facility where he has for the last 20 years. All right, I made my way to the office of Mr. LaRue Martin. How are you, sir?
I'm doing fine this afternoon. How are you doing?
I'm good. So you retired in December, yet you're still working. So tell me what's going on there.
Doing some volunteer work for UPS, keeping involved with the community. I had government affairs, too, and making sure that things are going in the right direction. It was a good assignment,
And go ahead.
I'm still getting calls on my office phone there, so I just go home and pick them up and see what I can do for the company.
Yeah, I imagine you get quite a few phone calls. You've worked for the company for over 30 years. You've been in the Chicago area for 20, but your roots start back. You're a Southsider. You were born and raised Southside, went to Loyola. Tell me that story real quick.
I started off at St. Anselm's Grade School. I was an altar boy back then. Went to De La Salle High School, all-boy prep school. I started off at CVS the first couple of months. I decided to make a change. I went to De La Salle High School, which was a very good career, and then I moved on to Loyola.
Yeah, you're a Hall of Famer. I think I would say that's a pretty good career, right?
Yeah, Hall of Famer there, De La Salle and Loyola University. It's been a good run. I was honored to be in the Hall of Fame, and I'm real low-key, though. People tell me, LaRue, you got a lot of history, but it's been good. It's been good. I never brag about myself. I just want to be sure that people are doing very well.
You mentioned that, you know, you don't like to brag about yourself, but people kind of want to push you out in front and say, well, maybe you should, just based on your accomplishments. I mean, you were a first round draft pick in the NBA right out of Loyola, and you played in the NBA for a little while, and then you had a life change, a pivot, and that's where your career at UPS started. Why don't you talk about that?
You know, I was number one draft choice back in 1972 with the Portland Trail Blazers, and my career was up and down. Didn't get that much playing time, but I had my degree. After I left the NBA, they wanted me to go to Europe, but I had a family to take care of, so I decided to go ahead and get a career. So I started off with Nike years ago as a marketing specialist, and I started their first factory outlet store in Portland, Oregon.
And that's where Nike's headquartered, right?
Yeah, in Oregon. And after that, some guys that lived in my neighborhood asked me, LaRue, you ever think about coming to work for UPS? I said, no, I'm doing well with Nike. But I decided to make a change. I went for the interview process, and they said I did very, very well. I said, well, what's next? Oh, you probably drive a package car. I said, what's a package car? That's a truck. But I went on ahead and did it, and I'm honored to do that. And back then, UPS didn't take me as a sports figure. They took me as an individual.
And you, when you started, though, you they had to make special uniform for you. I mean, how tall are you, sir?
I'm 7 feet. Back then.
Or you said 5 foot 24,
right? 5 foot 24. Yeah. They didn't have a uniform to fit me. So what I had to do, I had to get two pair of pants to cut the bottoms off of one and sew them onto the other so I have a uniform to fit me. And then I didn't have boots to fit me. I wear a size 18 shoes, so I took a pair of gym shoes and dyed them black.
At least you were comfortable.
Yeah. And when I was a driver for UPS, you know, we have bulkhead doors in our package cars, but they gave me a route in which I had to work out the back door because I couldn't fit in the bulkhead door.
Oh, my gosh. So you were Trailblazer all the way back then, no pun intended with the team name, I guess, but you worked with, I mean, you mentioned that you worked with Barack Obama and other high-profile figures. How did that happen in your career?
Well, I guess Christine Owens gave me this opportunity years ago to be the public affairs manager. I've met every congressman and congresswoman here in the state of Illinois. I have a good relationship with them. But then when Barack was a senator, I was the contact person for Barack Obama.
That's a pretty good number to have, huh?
I used to have his cell phone number, matter of fact. Then one year, it's called the Black Caucus in D.C., and he was speaking there that day. Okay, and UPS used to send me there, but when I went to D.C., I would go to Capitol Hill and knock on every congressman and congresswoman's door just to keep their relationship. It took me 2 days to do this.
Wow.
every time I went there, I did what I had to do. So he gave a speech at the dinner, black tie dinner. And my manager back then was Art Lucien. Art said, come on, LaRue, let's go back there and see the president. I said, Art, Secret Service is going to stop us, believe me. So we went behind the curtain, and of course, Secret Service said, halt, what are you doing? But the president saw me, LaRue, come on back here. What have you been doing? I haven't seen you in a while. What? And it was an honor. It was an honor.
That's a fantastic story. So you know a guy is what you're saying.
Yeah. Yeah.
So being from the south side of Chicago, and you've been all over, I mean, I imagine your travels have taken you far and wide.
The world. Yes, I have.
What's been your favorite moment in your career?
My greatest moment, playing against Will Chamberlain, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar back in the NBA days, playing against Dave Collins. You know, we called each other my brother from a different mother. Uh-huh. I talked to Dave about last week, as a matter of fact.
So you still keep in touch with some of those fellas, huh?
Well, every year we have about, say, 3 meetings. Of course, with the pandemic situation, we didn't have any meetings for the last couple of years. But I used to be on the board for the Retired Players Association, and one of my vice presidents, Lawrence Lewis, gave me the opportunity years ago to set up a little booth at one of our meetings to see if I can get some members to come to work for UPS. I'm proud of the Shield. It's treated me very, very well. I treated them very, very well. You keep your nose clean, you work hard, and do what you have to do. And this is a heck of a career here at UPS.
Right, and I think that's something special to talk about. I mean, you were the first round draft pick, you played in the NBA, and it just wasn't going where you wanted it to go. I mean, it takes a lot of guts to decide, you know what, I'm going to hang this up and try something else.
It was a tough situation, you know. I remember coming here years ago, back in 1972, and I don't talk about any coach or anything, but I didn't get 1 ounce of playing time. The number one draft choice, coming back to Chicago, at the old Chicago Stadium, no playing time. I had the opportunity to buy tickets for my family and friends. You know, tickets didn't cost that much back then.
Sure.
But I was hurt, and I will never forget that day. That was the most devastating thing in my life back then, not getting 1 ounce of playing time. I got tears in my eyes. I was embarrassed. But I've gotten older now. I moved on in life. And, you know, they still knocked me for being the worst draft choice. But I was the number one draft choice, but I was the number one community services manager for UPS years ago, too. And I just moved on in life.
Yeah, I think it's safe to say that you probably got the last laugh in the whole thing, because I imagine that day when your family's there and the old barn, they used to call it, didn't get to play. I imagine that was some kind of, I mean, it probably hurt and destroyed you on the inside, but also maybe it was a point where you used that to say, you know what, fine, I'm going to do something different, or maybe that was the beginning of a change that you wanted to do something different with your life.
It made me shy away from basketball for a while. I was disgusted, maybe with myself, and getting the playing time to prove the people that I could play. They wouldn't have drafted me number one,
right,
one thing. But, you know, life goes on, and you don't look back. You have to move forward. My thing was to put some horse binders on and go forward in your life. And when I got to work for UPS and Nike, I started to brighten up, lighten up a little bit. But I moved on in life. Being in a corporate structure, in the corporate world today, was really highlighting my career.
If people are interested in wanting to talk with you or anything like that, is there a website people can go to reach out or something like that?
My email address is l.jr8443@sbcglobal.net.
There you go. All right. Well, thank you. I appreciate you taking the time to talk with me and to help. And it's an honor to help tell your story. So thank you.
Thank you very much for coming by. I appreciate that. Sure. Thank you.
What an absolute pleasure talking to Mr. LaRue Martin. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. That's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, until then, I will see you later. Thanks for watching.